Dear veterinarians, welcome to YouTube channel on drvet. I am Dr. Praful Chandra Patel, Professor Veterinary Medicine. Today's lecture is on alkaline indigestion or rumen alkalosis in the ruminant. In this lecture, we'll study the etiology, pathogenesis, clinical findings, diagnosis, and treatment of alkaline indigestion in ruminants. Alkaline indigestion occurs due to heavy protein-rich feeding, and the disease is characterized by anorexia, dullness and depression, and by ruminal motility. Etiology of alkaline indigestion: it is due to ingestion of large quantity of protein-rich feed, especially the pulse seeds, excessive animal tissue which also contain protein, ingestion of placenta accidentally following parturition. Sometimes the cow after parturition ingest its own placenta. Ingestion of plants containing more protein. Nowadays there is craze of urea feeding and non-protein nitrogen substances, and this urea and non-protein nitrogenous substances are used for the processing of various livestock foods. Sudden change of ration from carbohydrate to protein, all this etiology leads to alkaline indigestion in animals. First, let us see what happens in pathogenesis normally. When protein is taken by animal or non-proteinous nitrogenous is taken by animal, this type of food is acted by ruminal microflora, and both these are converted to ammonia. This ammonia combined with carbohydrate derived keto acids to form amino acids, which is a part of a protein, and these amino acids are used for the synthesis of the cell microflora. This happens normally. Now, when the animal receives excessive protein feed, there is excessive production of ammonia, nitrogen, and decrease in volatile fatty acids. And this ammonia, being an alkali compound, it produces an alkaline pH of the rumen content, ranging from 7.5 to 9.5 pH. This alkaline pH decreases number of microbes in the rumen, and this leads to atony or weakness or paresis of the rumen, manifested by either hypomotility or atony of the rumen. Due to overproduction of ammonia, these microbes cannot utilize excess ammonia. And when the ammonia is more, it leads to a condition, ammonia intoxication. This excess overflow of ammonia is transported to liver, and in the liver it is converted to urea. And if there is excessive urea, it leads to a serious condition, urea poisoning in ruminants. Clinical findings of rumen alkalosis: there is partial anorexia to complete anorexia. Due to alkaline pH, there is paresis or weakness of the rumen wall. So there is ruminal hypomotility, both in amplitude and frequency. Number also decreased and the range also decreased. There is very mild abdominal pain manifested by kicking at the belly. In a mild form, there is complete recovery within few hours to few days. But when it causes a urea poisoning, the case may become serious, and the urea poisoning is manifested by three groups of symptoms: acute condition, subacute, and chronic urea poisoning. Signs of urea poisoning. There are three types of the signs: acute signs, subacute signs, and chronic signs. Acute signs means a severe sign, a severe disease condition. Severe abdominal pain. There is ammoniacal smell from the mouth because in the rumen there is overproduction of the ammonia. Tympany, ataxia, recumbency, convulsion, coma, and in very severe condition, a death in few hours. If the urea poisoning is subacute, it manifests moderate symptoms. Moderate abdominal colic, opisthotonus, means there is hyperextension of all limbs and the spasticity of the body. That means stretching of the body. The hind legs are stretched backward and tight. The forelegs are extended more forward and tight. The head is extended back and there is concavity of the back. This is the opisthotonous posture in moderate urea poisoning. Finally, there is shock. If the urea poisoning is continuous, then it manifests chronic mild symptoms, inappetence, rumen hypomotility, recurrent tympany again occurring again and again, and diarrhea. Clinical pathology. On examination of blood, the blood urea nitrogen increased from 15.3 milligram percent to 70 milligram percent, 5 to 6 times more. On examination of rumen fluid, the ruminant pH increased more than 7.5. Rumen lichen color dark brown. Odor from the rumen lichen ammonia like. The consistency watery, and due to death of the protozoa decreased. Diagnosis of alkaline indigestion. There is history of feeding of large quantity of proteinous feed. We have seen clinical findings: anorexia, ruminal atony, and mild abdominal pain. And more confirmatory diagnosis is the rumen fluid pH is alkaline more than 7.5. Treatment. The first treatment is the diet care. Immediately stop feeding proteinous feed and start feeding digestible carbohydrate feed Carbohydrate produce lactic acid. Proteinous feed produce ammonia, alkali. So stop proteinous feed and start feeding carbohydrate feed. Another line of treatment is take care of rumen microflora. Cud transplantation from other healthy animal. Orally provide vitamins and mineral supplement to reactivate the rumen microflora. Orally give antibiotics, penicillin or tetracycline or any other antibiotic which suppress the activity of the rumen microflora to prevent further production of the ammonia. Another line of treatment, correction of ruminal alkalosis. The rumen pH is alkaline. Give acetic acid 5 to 10% about 200 to 500 ml to an adult cattle either orally or intranominally. This is the best treatment. Acetic acid or vinegar is available in every kitchen. Lactic acid 50 to 70 ml in about 10 liter of water orally. Sodium propionate 50 gram orally. Another treatment, fluid and electrolyte and dextrose solution to avoid toxemia. Here there is ammonia and urea intoxication and hepatic detoxification. Last treatment, in severe cases there is complete emptying of the rumen. Take out all rumen content either by rumen lavage or rumenotomy. This rumen lavage procedure we have seen in our previous video on lactic acidosis. Dear veterinarian, thank you very much for observing the video on alkaline indigestion ruminants. Requested to share to our veterinary friends to provide good service to the animals. If you have liked this video, please press like button. Thank you very much.